Spotify had changed the way we listen to music, and their platform is quite remarkable when it comes to music streaming and discovery. Now, they're obviously focused on playlists in their design, which makes sense because this is how people listen to music today. However, this video is about the artist page, and in particular the about page. Let's see how and why I took this and turned it into this. From a listener perspective, this page is where we discover more about an artist and listen to their albums. From the artist's perspective, this page is where they can shine, their own home in a huge world of music, playlists, and artists. It's a place to build their brand, connect with their fans, share their work, promote their merchandise, and communicate concert dates. If listeners visit this page, they're either longtime fans or they're just discovering the artist. Either way, it's a place for first impression. This area should feel like the artist somehow. And translating a feeling through screen is hard. Spotify, just like any other platform, are working with templates. Every artist page looks the same, it's just the content that makes a difference. But can the interface help make a more unique experience? Are all interfaces the same, or can we design them in such a way that would evoke more personality? I'm not attempting to redesign the complete platform. I'm just trying to focus on one thing, the about page on the artist page. And the reason that I'm doing that is because it can get really complicated, and the only thing I'm trying to do here is to spark some inspiration and see how far we can go with something and think a little bit out of the box. And it's quarantine, so I don't really have much other stuff to do. The way I see it, the overview page is the entrance hall to the artist's home, and the about page is the living room. The current page is quite minimal. It has an image gallery, some links to the web, and a section with playlists, a bio, and some stats. I gave myself 1 hour for this redesign, and it turned to be a little more than 2 hours, and I'm still seeing things that could be improved. But it's a good start. Let's have a look at the process I went through. First thing I had to do here was to construct the foundation of the website. I picked the page of Thundercat for this project, just because Thundercat. Stay with me. I looked up the font Spotify used, and they actually have their own font, which made things a bit trickier. After a short research, I found Montserrat similar enough, so I'm gonna use that. There are some small differences, of course, that the A, for example, and the T, and it's also a bit shorter in height, and the weight is a bit different, but it'll do for this exercise. I tried to stay true to the original design with buttons and basic typography, so I literally took a screenshot and copied it. I also copied the biography text and cover image, but then I started deviating from the original design completely. I started thinking of it as a magazine, like a physical one that you open and you have this full spread of an article about an artist in Raygun in the 90s or a Rolling Stone. I really love these designs. They're unique and personal and impactful, and that's exactly the kind of thing I want to bring here. And this kind of layout isn't really realistic for a platform, obviously, because each article has its own complete, unique style and look. And Spotify is a platform, again, so this artist page is meant to be worked out by artists themselves. They should be able to just feed in all their information and create their own page. And these magazines are, like, really handmade. Someone really designed them. Every each of these articles is designed by a person. Nevertheless, I can be inspired by a magazine, by a physical magazine. I just need to keep in mind that this needs to be developed, programmed, and maintained by non-developers. To make it a bit more visually pleasing and dynamic, I played around with the images and created a little gallery that could break that huge block of text and create a bit more of an interest on the page. I've added a quote as well and brought the Discover More section that they had, which made me think this interface could actually be modular. The stats, merchandise, Discover More, playlists, concerts, bio, images, these are all elements that can be designed and developed by professionals as modules, and then artists could place them on the page where they want. This is obviously a long-term thinking for the company, and obviously I'm not working for Spotify, so there are a lot of things that I'm not really even taking into consideration here, just sitting and playing around with this design. But It's interesting to think about this in such a way. Also, looking at the current overview page of different artists, I've noticed that they don't really look exactly the same. So it seems like there are some sort of modules that artists can put around in different places. Again, I didn't really look into the technicality here, so I'm not really sure. But it seems like they have some sort of functionality of like modules. Artists can put different items on the page. Lastly, I've refined the typography. The original font seems a bit too small to my taste, and the amount of text is quite overwhelming and hard to read. I've made it, first of all, larger and cut the line length shorter. A good rule of thumb here is 70 to 80 characters within one line. It just makes it easier to read. And that's how far I got. Oh, and you might have noticed that I took out the sidebar, which can be quite critical. I mean, this is the core navigation of the platform. But I think it's worth it to explore the option of being able to toggle it in and out and create a more immersive experience when it's toggled out and you can really immerse yourself with a complete page. I hope the thoughts behind the creative process and design decisions I've made can spark some quarantine inspiration. If you like this, subscribe below. I'm gonna create more of these. If you think about other platforms or websites you would want me to look into and redesign, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.